What are the essential ingredients? What are the forces at work? What are the underlying principles? In our day-to-day activities, we know what's within arm's reach in our everyday environment, and we're somehow blind to the exquisite detail of the universe. To unveil these mysteries, we have to go beyond our everyday experiences, and we have to go into some special conditions. We have to magnify, and we have to amplify to be able to unveil what are the fundamental ingredients of the universe. I'm Kyle Cranmer. I'm a professor at New York University. My research is based at CERN and the Large Hadron Collider. We've been looking for new forms of matter, the basic building blocks and the fundamental ingredients of the universe. And in my spare time, I'm an amateur beer drinker. Recently, we discovered a particle called the Higgs boson, sometimes called the God particle, and really like a key to our understanding of how the universe works. The Higgs permeates the whole universe, and it just affects everything that's inside. So I guess it's like how hops permeates beer. And to understand it, you really need to extract it and study it in its purest form. This is why we explore new frontiers, and this is where we make new discoveries. Things that are very small, tiny particles turn out to be teeming with a sea of activity inside. When we look up in the sky, big, diffuse, motionless-looking galaxies are actually made up of billions and billions of stars that are undergoing this epic dance at the grandest of scales. Technology allows us to sense what was previously inaccessible, and it enhances the clarity of our knowledge. But whether you're peering through a microscope or you're gazing through a telescope at the vastness of space, technology can really only take you so far. While it's science, there's also an art to it. I mean, we have to use creative yet rigorous methods, and that's equally true whether or not you're talking about studying the universe or searching for new particles or crafting a new beer. And that discovery, no matter how esoteric, is an achievement that really we can all relish. At CERN, to study the Higgs, we focus beams of particles with a tremendous amount of energy, and they collide and they actually create something new. They create the Higgs boson, and the way that we see it in our experiments is something we call a resonance.
Really high resonance.
To study the hops, Sixpoint is building upon their knowledge and focusing a tremendous amount of creative energy to create something, and the way that we experience it, well, that's high res.